What are the characteristics of facial aging? Well, believe it or not, you subconsciously are looking at faces and you are deciding on what age that person looks, okay? Now, for any particular age, the patient could be younger or older. So there's a difference between a chronological age and your physiological age. So your chronological age is the age you actually are, and your physiological age is the age your body is, okay? Now, there are different aspects of facial aging. So these are the things you're looking at without even knowing it, okay? So the first is active lines, the second is volume loss, and the third is skin quality. So active lines are generally treated by weakening the overactive muscle. So for instance, someone who's got a really strong frown line, that's caused by muscle activity. The logical way of reducing it is to reduce the muscle activity, okay? Skin changes, if someone's got terrible, terrible skin, the sensible treatment is to reverse those skin aging treatments, but even better, prevent them from coming in the first place. And gravity changes unfortunately affect us all. As we age, our soft tissues become slightly less adherent to the underlying skeleton, and tissue goes down. So we talk about this a lot, about the gravity changes, but essentially they're a surgical and non-surgical ways with fillers and dermal toxins to reduce the gravity changes. So we talk about this a lot, how to analyse faces, the main aspects of facial ageing, and most importantly, how to advise your patients about the most appropriate treatments for them to give them a subtle, natural rejuvenation.